Lord.
Kama yebaziwe.
Okay, today I want to talk about
olwaleero njagala kwogera
poverty
kubwavu
and riches
n'obugagga.
The reason I talk about it,
ensonga lwaki nkyogerako,
I have a mantle on my life
ndiko omunagiro ku bulamu bwange
to break the spirit of poverty
kumenya omwoyo gw'obwavu.
And I can't talk much about this
sisobola kwogera bingi ku kino
because you are, some of you are witnesses
kubanga bamukumwe bajulizi.
Some of you have testimonies. The way you came in my life and what you are today, it is a proof that God sent me and I have something on my life. This one thing which God told me, that not all at once but step by step, and each step is always a miracle. And my dear brethren, if you fail to understand this, that godly things are not done over a night, you can't see God in your life. I want you to understand that godly things are not done at once. Even you yourself, when you were born, and you took stages to grow year after year. Every year you were changing. Every year there was a change until when you reached where you are. The stage which everyone say that at least now you are old, you are mature. After 18 years they count you a mature person who can make decisions. Praise the Lord. So brethren, I want you to understand this, but if you are, you've put your issue before God,
the things don't happen once.
Bigenda bigira mu stages.
They come in through different stages.
And you have to learn to thank God for each stage which comes your way. Amen.
Amen.
Some people fail to receive from God because they think that things are going to work at a terrific speed. And that is not godly. Godly things come from stage to stage and stage by stage, not all at once, step by step, not all at once. Amen. Which means learn to appreciate every stage which comes your way. Amen. You have to be observant. Many times I make this statement that sinatuuka gye ndaga.
That I haven't gotten to where I'm going. But I'm not where I started from.
It means that you must be observant and thank God for each step. Amen. Some people can't thank God because they always compare themselves to others. And that is not a godly spirit. You should always compare yourself to your background. Where
did you come from? Where are you today? When you get to that stage,
brethren, you will begin to thank God. If you
get to that stage,
thank God for what you are today.
Okubaza Katonda ku lwekyo ky'oliyo leero.
N'owetunuulira.
And you look at yourself.
N'okuba flashback.
And you make a flashback.
Wali otya 2 years ago?
How are you? I mean, I can't
wali tosobola kufuna kyakulya?
You couldn't even get something to eat.
Naye olwaleero.
But today.
Osobola okubaamu n'emitwalo abiri.
You can have 200,000.
Eri abalina miliyoni abiri.
There are those who have 20 million.
Buli muntu n'olugendo lwe.
Everyone has their own journey. But you started from somewhere. If you fail to look
at
and compare even with where you are today, today even if you're sick, but before you would not even have money to take you to hospital. Before, Utalo was a struggle. But now you need to thank God. You still rent. You haven't gotten a car. You haven't gotten married. You haven't married. But you're not in the same position as you were before. You didn't have a mattress. But now you have a mattress. Things are piling slowly.
Amen.
Amen. So if you fail to understand that, forget about the things of God. Because the truth is that even your baby,
last Friday,
if you gave birth to your baby or rocked
on or janga.
And by the time you get to the coming Friday, they have appeared. And you find your baby in bed when they've
happened.
You can first jump. And you run. And you call the police. There's something in my bed. You know, and the baby has beards like
for Friday.
You give birth to this baby last
Friday.
They have a very thick beard.
Mama.
Then they're like,
Mom.
With a very hoarse voice. I can shout. I call the police. I call the neighbors. And I tell the police, come on and beat this phantom for me.
Amen.
Amen. Why do you want your business to grow? Quickly like that. Yet you've not learned anything. Even if it is your business. Even if it is a person. Everything has growth. Even ministry has to grow. You've started a church. You want in a
church.
The church to be a global. It is impossible.
Today
you may see us here. And you think we started yesterday. But this church is 28 years. It is growing slowly. When we look at where we are today. We don't compare ourselves with others. No. According to where we've
been.
Where we are today. God has done a lot.
Amen.
Amen.
Today I'm talking about poverty.
When time allows me,
I'm going to talk about riches because I have the ability from God to make you a rich person.
That does not assure me. There are people that came into my hands when they were learned. But they had nothing. But today they have something. It does not
assure me.
There are people that came into my hands. When they were not learned. But today they are even better than the land. It's not a shaming
for me
to even mention their names. When I talk about Mr. Vogere, there's something that I mean.
The
person who said that he never went to school, he spoke. Maybe he didn't go further in studies. But today, there are people that he accommodates.
Azimbe nyumba.
He has built houses.
Azimbe kalina.
He has built storied
buildings.
He has rentals.
Atambula nga mugaga.
He moves like a rich person.
Alina amataka.
He has land. Everything is available.
Chiva kuchecho.
What causes that?
Oluwa amanya agachikora.
There's power that does it.
Agaveri katonda.
There's power that comes from God.
There's
also power that does the things of the devil. And I want to tell you that even the devil gives wealth. But the riches of God and the riches of the devil have a difference. God's riches.
Proverbs 8 verse 18.
Mungero munana, ulinyoro kumina munana. Alina
cha agamba.
He says something.
Anachaita enduring riches.
Proverbs 8:18.
Mm.
Riches and honor are with me.
Mm.
Enduring riches and righteousness.
Thank you. Again.
Riches and honor are with me, enduring riches and righteousness.
In Uganda. Obugaga n'ekitiibwa biri nange, oba obugaga bwe nkalakkalira n'obutuukirivu. Praise the Lord.
Mukama yeebazibwe.
Katonda ekyo ky'offeringa.
That is what God offers.
Ne Sitaani alina obugaga bw'agaba.
There's also riches that the devil gives.
Obugaga bwa Sitaani.
The riches from the devil.
Bubaamu obuyinike.
They have sorrow attached.
Tebubeerera.
They are not enduring.
Teri omuntu yali afunye obugaga mu mayembe.
There's no one who has ever gotten riches through demons.
N'owulira nti n'omwana yabusikidde.
And you hear that even their child was able to be a success of that of those riches.
Bible yega nti ennaku zenga zikyali za kitundu.
The Bible says that when their days are still
up. Buli mukiwako.
The riches will be taken away from them.
Era abantu bangi nnyo obugaga bubavuddeko.
And so many people have lost their riches.
Enkomerero ne babanga abasirusiru.
At the end they look like fools.
Kubanga Bible bwetu bwegamba.
Because so the Bible says.
Nkinyumira nnyo mu Luganda.
I enjoy it in Luganda.
Mu Yeremia esura 17.
In Jeremiah 17.
Verse 11. Lugamba bweruti.
This is what it says.
Lugamba bweruti. Ng'enkwale bw'ekuŋŋaanya obwana bw'etezaalanga.
As a partridge that broods but does not hatch.
Bwatyo bw'abeera oyo omuntu afuna obugagga so si lwa mazima.
So is he who gets riches but not by right.
Ennaku ze nga zikyali za kitundu.
When he's in the midst of his days.
Buli buvaako.
He will lose it.
N'enkomerero ye aliba musirusiru.
And at his end he will be a fool.
Ennaku ze nga zikyali za kitundu.
In the midst of his days.
Buli muvaako.
He will lose his riches.
N'enkomerero ye.
And at his end.
Aliba musirusiru.
He will be a fool.
Basitebe ne banyabo nga sinaba kusumulula ku kyeŋŋenda kwogera.
Gentlemen and ladies, before I start on what
nkyakola bukozi foundation.
I'm still making a foundation.
Era bwoba wakazuukuka.
And if you've just woken up.
Nabako mu maaso.
Please wash your face.
Otegere bulungi bye ŋŋamba.
And understand what I'm saying.
Tozibibwanga amaaso.
Never be blinded.
N'ogenda okunoonya obugagga wa Sitaani.
And you go to look for riches from the devil.
Fenna twagala sente.
We all want money.
Sitaani tasobola butabukuwa.
The devil cannot fail.
Singa otuukiriza terms and conditions.
As long as you fulfill the terms and conditions.
Naye nkomerero yo.
But your end.
Ogenda kuba musirusiru.
You're going to be a fool.
Kubanga bugenda kuvaako.
Because you're going to lose your riches.
Obugagga bwa Sitaani.
The riches of the devil.
Busangibwa mu basawo abaganda.
With the witches.
Abasawo abakinnansi.
Or those traditional witches.
Ne cult churches.
N'amakanisa agatali ga Katonda.
Waliwo amakanisa agalimu occultism.
That have occultism.
Ng'eno basoma Bible.
They read the Bible.
Naye ng'eno balinga abalinga abagaba obugagga.
But it's like they're giving riches.
Balina ebintu byabwe.
They have things that they do.
Era osobola okubeera mu cult church n'ogimanya.
And you can be in a cult church and you know it.
Omutima gwogwo gusooka okubuulira.
Your heart tells you first.
Nti eyo si ya Katonda.
That is not a godly church.
Omutima gwogwo kubuulira.
Your heart tells you.
Then bwe gumala okubuulira.
And then after it tells you.
N'ebibala byabwe osobola okubiraba.
You can even see their fruits.
Buli lw'obeera mu kanisa eri cult.
Every time you're in a cult church.
Tebatuza bulokozi.
They don't lead you to salvation.
Tebagenda kuyita bagamenti waliwo alokoka.
They are not going to call you and tell you come and confess salvation.
Ate cult churches zibuzabuza.
And these cult churches are confusing.
Olumu zisaba ebyobulogo ne babyokya.
Sometimes they even ask you for those witchcraft items.
Bonoloza nti batuufu.
And you think that they are the right people.
Naye ng'ate baba balimba.
But they are lying.
Amina. Cult churches.
These cult churches.
Zirina ebizibu byazo.
They have their own challenges.
Ebibala byazo osobola obimanya.
You can see their fruits.
Bajjudde okutya.
They are full of fear.
Batisatisa abantu.
They threaten people.
Tebakkiriza muntu kusabirako mu kanisa ndala.
They don't allow people to pray from another church.
Ndowooza tebaagala bazuula.
I think they don't want to be discovered.
Ensomesa yaabwe ogiwulira.
You listen to their teaching.
Owulirira ddala teaching nga teri ku mulamwa.
Feel that the teaching is not on point.
Otunuulira abantu abo.
You look at those people.
Nawe n'omanya nti.
And you know.
Abantu bano si ba Katonda.
These people are not godly.
Naye omuntu yenna owa Katonda.
But anyone who is godly.
Omulabira ku bibala bye.
You see them by their fruits.
N'omwoyo gwe okukubuulira.
And even your spirit can tell you.
Amina.
Amen.
Kakati. So those are the two places where the devil gives riches.
Amen. Kati
as the born again,
as
we are washed by the blood of Jesus, we look for one thing.
Yes,
we want the riches.
Enduring riches. The Bible says
that leaves riches for his children's children. We look for our end.
It
is something that you can show for people. The riches of the born again, they come from promises. And if God is indeed there, the truth is by the time you die, God has done everything. What I've discovered among the born again is that they can start well and they end up badly. Why? Because on their journey they forget God. And they forget what God told them. And at the end of it all, God walks away.
And
they, for him they remain with something.
Amen.
Amen.
Do
you know that you can have a church? A church that is on the right track. And God is with you.
But
I've sent you to do this and that. Every time you move away from
what
you do, and you do your own thing,
his presence lifts. You continue with what you want. The
people who are in that church, and they don't see the promises of God. But now we look at the man Joshua.
Bible
the Bible says that he called his children when he was of age. I think in Joshua 23, verse 14. Joshua 23. Verse 13. I know for certain that the Lord your God will no longer drive out these nations from before you, but there shall be snares and traps to you, and scourges on your sides and thorns in your eyes, until you perish from this good land which the Lord your God has given me. Behold, this day I am going the way of all the earth, and you know in all your hearts and in all your souls that not one thing has failed of all the good things which the Lord your God spoke concerning you. All have come to pass for you. Not one word of them has failed.
Thank you so much. Can I read it in Luganda for people who don't understand English? Mutegere daranga mukama katona amwe. Tagobira tagobenganate amawanga gano mumaso gamwe. Na ye ganabanga mutego. Necha ambika jemuli. Oruga kumbirizi za mwe na magwa maso ga mwe okutuka lwemulizikirira okuva mu nsi eno ennungi mukama wammwe gye yabawa kama katona mwe gye yabawa era leero nindo olugendo ebintu byonna gye bigenda oluna agenda kufa nammwe mumanyi mu mitima gyammwe gyonna ne mu mmeme zammwe zonna nga tewali kigambo kimu ekitatuuse mu birungi byonna Katonda ammwe bye yaboogerako byonna bituukiridde tewali na kimu ekitatuuse Mukama yeebazibwe. Kansoma Oluganda Katikkiro anaabazze temundoopa Mukama waffe yeebazibwe. Amiina. Abooluganda Mukama yeebazibwe. Bino byonna byonna
all these things,
bino byonna,
all these things,
byali mu biseera bya Yesu,
happened in the days of Joshua.
Yayita abantu be.
He called his people.
N'abagamba, Mukama yamwolesanga agenda.
I think God told him that he was going to die.
N'amugamba ngenda.
Then he said,
"Olugendo,
the way."
Ebintu byonna abantu bonna gye bagenda.
All things or all people go.
Amen.
Amen.
Nina abagamba mumanyidde ddala.
But he told them that you know.
Mu mitima gyammwe.
In your hearts.
Natwali kigambo n'ekimu.
Not one word
Mukama kye yaboogerako
that God spoke concerning you
has failed to come to pass. And he said, every word has come to pass. Every word has come to pass. Amen. Listen, my brother. They call the riches of the born again.
It
starts with promises. But promises, some promises don't come to
pass.
Because if the one who fulfills promises is not there,
so
all the other things work.
If the presence of God is with
you,
if God is still with you, whatever he spoke concerning you comes to pass. This is what I know. So many people fail to get good things, not because God doesn't want to give them, but just because God is not with them. Amen.
Amen.
You can do something small and it takes away the presence of God. So even if you have many rhema words, those rhema words will never come to pass. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Today I want to talk about poverty. Before I begin to elaborate or to dig deep, let me first explain what poverty is. Poverty is a condition where people cannot meet their basic human needs. Like
a
proper housing, clean water, healthy food, and medical attention. I repeat, poverty is a condition where people cannot meet their basic human needs. Like a proper housing, clean water, healthy food. And medical attention. Praise the Lord. Again, poverty is a state or condition in which a person or community, lacks the financial resources for a minimum standard of living. I repeat, poverty is a state or condition which a person or community lacks the financial resources, for minimum standard of living.
Tebaina bintu muva sente okusobola okutuuka ku bulamu embeera y'obudeta embeera y'obulamu etandikirwako.
Amen.
Amen.
Standard of living. Minimum standard of living.
Omutindo gw'obulamu ogutandikibwako.
I continue. Poverty is much more than just not having enough money.
Obwavu kisingako tekitegeeza butegeeza nti omuntu talina ssente wabula kisingako obutaba na ssente.
Poverty means that a person does not make enough money from their job to meet their basic needs.
If you're found in such situations, we call you a poor person. There are some nations in the
UK,
and they were declared as poor nations.
Amen.
Amen. But they were not poor. But it means that even if someone is in a good life, there are still other chances. They can be poor again.
Amen. Causes of poverty.
There
are two causes. There is a cause which is natural, and there is a spiritual cause. Let me start with these natural causes. Amen. Unemployment. If you are not employed, poverty will knock on your door. If we talk of employment, according to me, I've been telling you that not all jobs can bring in money. And the devil is very cunning. If you don't know what you are asking for from God, He can give you the job when He has already calculated that if this person works or gets this job, this person or this job will make this person poor forever. Which job? Jobs like you don't save, you get money, it feeds you, you pay your bills, and then the money is done. Yes, you are employed, but that job cannot add on you anything. If you have that job, even if you are employed, you can't fight poverty. Amen.
Amen.
According to me, if you are to fight poverty, you have to get the right job. Right according to God. Amen.
Amen. I'll get back to that.
Another cause of poverty was
entalo.
Ugandans, you want wars. Wars
entalo
at the place of work.
Kumirimo.
Wars
entalo
at home.
Awaka.
In families.
Mufamiliza mwa.
In churches.
Makanisa.
All these things cause poverty. Intalo zileta okubeera nti abantu
was cause people
they tebawumudde.
People are not settled, they are not resting.
They move from one place to another.
Batambula ne bava mu kifo ekimu nga badda mu kirala.
Their minds are not at peace.
Ebirowoozo byabwe nga tebiwummudde.
So that one causes poverty.
Kati ekyo ne kireeta obwavu.
Another cause of poverty.
Kireeta obwavu ekirala.
Is debt.
Lye amabanja.
Living under debt.
Okubeera wansi w'ebbanja.
Ugandans.
Bana Uganda.
Edda walingawo ebibiina.
They used to be groups.
Bia jampola mpola kumbibireta bwavu.
Slowly, yet they were bringing poverty.
Bibina biwala sente.
Those groups that lend money.
Obino wona wera bira.
I forgot about.
Biwaliwo miaka nga 30 years ago.
But they were there miaka nga 3 mabega.
Nga buli mu byalo.
They were in villages and communities. Simani
banange eno wafe ne kasanga teno.
I don't know in Kasanga.
Bwali nga yonyo.
They were there.
Simani babu itangani. Omo nina kumumanya abena babira kendeno. Teka nawe. Kama yeba zivama. Ama ubina wali na manya gabu. Ibula mwa wali wa kabina. Ibula mwa wali mkazi ya janga.
Ngaula
sente.
And she used to.
Ngawaloni. Ngasumisa na abana.
She also used to teach.
Chati ubina wali nga wano.
So they used to some the government used to abolish them. And people would be like, you know, get like 5 people.
Baba sente.
And they would give you money. And then they kept on growing. Such groups. They brought a lot of problems. And they caused people to think that someone has to live by debt. I believe that God can allow you to take a debt. And He can pay it. Let me tell you this. I told you that I did a lot of meditation on this. The Bagandas who are hunters.
Abayizi.
During the days of old. They had a belief. When they go to hunt an animal.
There is a demon which hunts with them. And they used to call it dungu. And they have a saying which says dungu aize.
That dungu has hunted.
But
when you look at it,
dungu is not visible.
Dungu talabika.
Amen. Dungu is not visible.
Dungu talabika.
They go to hunt with their dogs. The dogs are theirs.
Embwazawe.
The nets.
Ebitimba.
The spears.
Amafumo.
Kigama olaba party yonayone singa yabo.
It's like they've done the most part.
Nebo bakwasa.
But when they get a catch.
Bama nyinti dungu ya taiza ya pawado usobuzo kwasa.
They know that it's dungu has given them the ability to get the catch.
I
said, but what stops us the born again to think that even if I'm the one who is learned, I'm the one who has gone to school,
I can fail if there is no hand of God or Lion of Judah to hunt for me. I don't know whether I get my idea. This is my idea.
Chino chirozo change.
Believers should start.
Muino kutandika.
You should start knowing.
Muino kutandika kumanya.
That.
Nti.
Even if you have the ability.
Nevo bango ino obusobozi.
Or you have business.
Obango ina business.
Maybe you are dealing in real estate.
Ovoria ongo okolagana mbia real estate bya mataka na mayumba.
You have houses to sell.
Mayumba go tunda.
Lands. You have injected in money.
Gotade musente.
But you have to know.
Nayo ino okumanya.
That there is a dungu.
Tiwaliwo dungu.
We don't believe in dungu. For us we believe in Jesus Christ.
Tukiriza mu Yesu Kristo.
The Lion of Judah.
Pologoma ya Yuda.
To hunt for us.
Tuyigira.
Without him.
Watari.
In business.
Mo business
we ya. Cannot make a catch.
Tetusobola kubako chetukwasa.
You don't see him physically.
Tomulaba mbuliwo.
But you must have that thinking.
Oyino kubera nendowoze iyo.
Until Jesus is ahead of me.
Mpaka nga Yesu ankulembe.
I cannot have a catch.
Sisobola kubako chenkwasa.
I think you understand.
Ndoza mutegera.
Yesu yagamba nti ebyensi bibayigirize eby'eggulu.
Jesus said, let the worldly things teach you the heavenly things.
Kati ekizibu kiri kimu.
So the problem is one.
Amaaso twagajja ku Yesu, the Lion of Judah.
Focusing on the Lion of Judah.
To hunt for you.
Okuyigira.
And you started doing things by yourself.
Watandika okwekolera ebintu.
N'otetenkanya.
And then you're doing things here and there.
Mpayo loan.
Give me a loan.
Tetugana.
We are not denying that.
Mukama wabaya kulunganiza nti likubo.
If it is God who has guided you that is the way.
It is okay.
It is okay.
Negwanga liene diewola.
Even a nation can borrow.
Nebuli rota niko kulunganiza nti chorino kola.
But every time you start thinking that is
if what you are lacking.
Bovanga
obula. You go to a money lender.
Ogenda wa money lender.
Unless the Lord guides you.
Because
we are called sheep. Because a shepherd goes ahead of us. The reason why people are in deep debt, they forsook the life of faith. And the life of faith is the life of guidance. Because walking by faith is walking by hearing from God. You hear from God. You hear what God says. You hear God's direction concerning your matter. But people forsook all that. And they started kwetetenkanya. You don't have money.
Torina sente.
First go to God.
Soko genderi katoni.
Cry to God.
Kabirira katoni.
You are my father.
Oli tata wange.
Where is the green grass?
Omuddo.
Show me where the green grass is.
Omuddo mutowe guri.
Show me where the still waters are.
Amaza matefu wega.
You are my shepherd.
Yego msumba.
Please guide me.
Nungamia.
Lead me.
Nungamia.
That is the life of a Christian.
Ovevulamo ovomolokole.
But things went astray because you started kwetetenkanya. Amen.
Amen.
You started doing things by yourself. You forsook the life of faith. You forsook the life of asking God, what can I do? What can I use? Even if funds are available.
Money can become a snare for you when God is not going to use it to bring a blessing your way. Someone can even tell you, let me give you money.
But
the devil has set a trap for you. There's no blessing in that money. And you lose all of it. And then you start paying debt.
So what about guidance?
That is why you doesn't stop in only spiritual things.
Because
even in financial things.
Let me stop.
But
some of the causes of poverty is debt. Another cause of poverty is overpopulation. Overpopulation causes poverty, especially in Africa. There's a lot of poverty because of overpopulation. And in those sides of Asia, India, other parts.
There's so many people. And nations have to prepare for those people.
Overpopulation is another cause of poverty. Plan well. Stop, if possible. I don't know the plan of the government to stop this overpopulation or to hinder. Because today, I know the reason why people are, the population is growing.
So many children are not going to school.
So they start
getting pregnant and conceiving kumiyake mito.
They
start giving birth at an early age. And those who are giving birth don't have jobs.
So the
only thing they can get is food and what to wear. So it's difficult to eradicate poverty.
Amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. Another cause is laziness or lack of effort. Laziness is another cause of poverty. Oversleeping. Amen.
Amen.
Another cause of poverty. Alcohol and drug addiction.
You go to the ghetto and you cannot
use the program.
It's recently I was watching a program of the children from the ghetto.
Banamawulire bagendayo.
The journalists went there.
Nimpo chinga nalisimanya.
And I watched, I did not.
Banono bali bageto bakalerwe.
These were ghettos from
Bavuka.
Young men.
Beita bageto youth.
They call themselves the ghetto youth.
Naichi wa manchirichim.
But what they know is one.
Kuyimba lu Jamaica.
Singing Jamaica.
Basi baba yimba.
They spend the whole day singing.
Bo ani kubugaro hubiributi.
They lift up their two fingers.
Nibongira uru Jamaica.
They speak Jamaican.
Ainza nukua techi Congo lilo naguito muzindaro.
They can even get amazing.
Eri solimiufu we miu.
Their eyes are very red.
Kati wachita kukubeka bazi kumutwe.
So why wouldn't they hit you?
Kubanga wadayimbi.
Because even if they've
sung. Kuyimba kote kulimu sende.
There's no money in their singing.
Balina bana baba inspiring.
They have people who inspire them.
Aba fudeyo.
Those who have been able to make it.
Niba fuka ba celebrity.
And they've become celebrities.
Anosanga bavubu kangabili.
And you find like 20.
Unabona balimu practice.
Ngabalimu kutubumu kwete ndeka.
Mugire vitu tuyota tegira.
They're speaking things that you don't even understand.
Amina.
Amen.
So alcohol and drug addiction
is
another cause of poverty. Another cause of poverty is lack of skills and ability. Lack of skills.
You don't even have
something that you can. Skills in the one word of Kugu.
Any skill. You don't have any skill.
No one skill of one mutwe.
Maybe you learn, you know, about the sewing machine, you know how to tailor.
And those chandwa dainty, what do I soma?
It should be, even if you're
learning,
there should be another job that you know, another skill that you
possess.
Developed nations, a person cannot have one job.
Maybe
they're from office.
Oh, South office. Apart
from jam,
go out.
Time to leave office should be 5 p.m.
You go home. Prepare. Supper.
No, teka teke chikuro.
Sabili obuwe na uinzo kubanga olina olaba TV yongo nibi ndo vila vio kwa saganya.
Maybe at 8 p.m. you're watching TV and you're doing some other things.
Amen.
Amen.
Okusinzi na kubana Uganda.
According to Ugandans.
Buba loza nanti okuba no mulimu gomuto buhavu. Uba mirimu java once.
They think that having a skill, it's a job done by poor people. But then when you look at it, countries like Italy and countries like China, those countries that are developed, the jobs that you think are lowly, today they are the jobs that bring in money.
Batunzi, abataki batunzi.
In Turkey.
Akwanti okutunga kwa bakati bage na kwa advanced stages.
But it's just that the tailoring is on an advanced stage.
Kati okutusanga ideology yo, what that mind it vudemu.
Until we do our
own
that
ideology.
To think that when someone plays here, that is a lowly job. All those things bring poverty. You start despising work. It brings poverty. There's a gentleman that I usually observe
that
side of Chisasi Bukoto.
They have
a place, they roast chicken.
He's
a very respectful man.
Ekifocha bachikola bulungi nyo.
They did their place well, they worked their place well.
Abantu ba class.
And it hosts classy people.
Balina esigiri nunji.
They have nice charcoal stoves.
Nchigenda mu.
I go to that place.
Nintunula. Baplaninga parking weri.
There's parking.
Parking up pavers.
You park on pavers.
Kifo chita mu impewo.
It is an aerated place.
Nchitunulia nene unya.
I look at it and I wonder.
Sigiri nunji nyo.
Good charcoal stoves.
Bayonjo nyo.
They're very clean.
And
they roast a chicken.
Chicken
is rolling.
Ne kalaburunji.
And it dries.
Buluchimu chona kugamba. Bulichumba chikola bulungi.
They do everything very well.
Nintu nuliro mwami.
But I look at this gentleman.
N'abantu abajjawo.
And the people that come there.
Ningamba. Singa abantu bayigira ku mwami ono.
And I'm like, I wish people learn from this gentleman.
N'abeerawo.
He's there.
N'asupervisinga.
And he supervises.
Obuyonjo buli wali.
There's cleanliness.
Okitegeera. Bamala eyidde ba orders ezimuzigira ku masimu.
Some orders come on phones.
Abalala bajja ne ordering nga babeera mu mamotoka.
People come and order, they
sit. Yateekawo ne eating place.
Yateekawo ne ekifo w'oyinza okuliira.
Byonna biri class.
Everything is class.
Natunuulira omwami ono ngamba.
I looked at the gentleman.
Akola sente meka olunaku.
How much money does he make in a day?
Ng'oggyeeko olunaku.
Putting aside a day.
Ngo bw'aba tali awo.
If he's not there.
N'omusanga mu kifo ekirala.
Even if you find him in another
place. Ng'apakinze benzi simanyi oba alina emmotoka.
When he has parked his benzi.
N'ateeka okuba alina.
I don't know if he has a car, but he should be having.
Ayinza okutunuulira gwe ayogera oluzungu lwo.
He can look at you, you who is speaking your English.
Nga teruliiko wadde nusu.
And you don't even have money.
Nga weepankapanka obwo obutaayitaayi obutalina wadde ekikumi.
Bragging with your ties.
Mukama waffe yeebazibwe. Waliwo ebintu omubye ebinsoomooza.
There are some things that challenge me.
Ngamba poverty.
I'm like,
praise the Lord. Okay, effects of poverty.
Biki ebiva mu bwavu.
Family problems.
Ebizibu mu maka.
The poor at a great risk of family problems.
Abavu bali mu kati abagaka amaanyi nnyo okufuna ebizibu by'omu maka.
Like divorce.
Nga okwawukana.
Domestic violence.
N'obutabanguko mu maka.
Increase in school dropout rates.
Amen.
Amen.
These
are all effects of poverty. Mental health issues. Like stress.
Okubeera mu stress.
Anxiety.
Okweraliikirira okutagwawo.
And depression.
N'okwenyika.
Another effect. High rates of crime like theft. High rates of crime. High rates of crime like theft.
Like theft.
Amen. And another effect, insufficient access to health care.
Amen.
Amen.
All those things are effects of poverty.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Now, obwavu bwe buli mu nsi.
So there's poverty in the world.
Katika tuogere ku kanisa.
But now let's talk about the church.
What does
God think
kukanisa
about the church?
Wakati mawavu.
In the midst of poverty.
Obwavu webuli.
There is poverty.
Na ye odinokusoko kuchimanya.
But you have to know.
Nti behind poverty.
Tia mabiga wavu.
There is a spirit.
Wali wa moyo.
An evil spirit.
Moyo mubi.
And a curse.
Nechikolimo.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
According to God,
okusinzira Katonda,
these things
ebintu bino
are caused
bireetewa
by a spirit.
Moyo.
Some people may not believe it.
Abantu abo bayinza obutakikkiriza.
But behind an emotion,
naye emabega wa buli kintu kyonna ekitalo,
is always either a good force or a bad force.
Okubeerayo amabi obanga mabi obanga malungi.
If you see anything in motion, there must be in the invisible world, there is something, there is a spirit, either good spirit or a bad spirit. A good spirit brings good results, causes good results, and bad spirits causes bad results. We as Christians, we know very well that if you are to overcome poverty, you must fight the spirit first. The spirit which causes all this which causes poverty. But before you fight the spirit, you fight the curse called poverty. Because the curse gives the spirit a legal right to work in that person's life or in that community. If you are to bring a curse, you use the blood of Jesus. Because Jesus became a curse, that we may become the blessing of God. If you are to overcome poverty, use the blood of Jesus. How? By getting saved. Amen. You first offer your life. You give your life wholly to Christ. That is the number one. If you are to get riches, enduring riches, you give your life to Christ.
The whole of your life.
Do you believe it? Or you are just listening to the radio? Praise the Lord.
Amen.
If you are to see changes and overcome the spirit of poverty, you first break the curse called poverty. How do you break it? Give your life to Christ. Lokoka.
Become born again.
Chiba ito kulokoka.
What they call becoming born again.
Chizi ingiramu confession.
It includes okwatula.
Kwango jaga mama narokoka angasika gawala.
Because you say I'm born again but I'm not yet.
Katulide vya ngonzo kuba lokoka bifu.
Maybe you're not born again the right way.
Did you confess?
Wayatula.
Right salvation doesn't mean that you go to Pastor Rwama's church and you begin fellowship. Fellowshipping in Balokole churches doesn't make you a born again. Just because you came to church and I prayed for you and you received, so you made a decision to pray with us, that doesn't make you a born again. And if you are like that,
you've never been born again. A born again person,
the
time comes and you come to
it
and you believe with your heart and you confess it with your mouth. Because someone, even if it's not a priest, and that person leads you to Jesus. There's someone who should lead you to Jesus. Anyone can help another confess. You can help your husband.
After
they confess, then you take them to church. After you confess salvation,
you give or you surrender. You surrender everything to Christ and then you receive the Holy Spirit. That is your
Stays have been calling him a bridal stylist.
Because
you are bright.
Ayingira munda na akujamu na akusale enjala.
And he works on the nails, scrubs your feet, and he really puts
you bao Yesu agendo kuja.
Right, and when he
burunji, that,
when he comes, then you're well. So I will not call,
him a shepherd.
Jamu ito msumba.
Your chief pastor.
Msumba wa mkuru.
Yes, you have a local church, but the Holy Spirit is your pastor. I don't know where you stay, but he's always with you. Where you stay, he guides you. He tells you, don't. Do's and don'ts. Don't go there, go this way. Don't go with those people. Yes. You receive the Holy Spirit. When you receive the Holy Spirit, The time comes.
Sera chituoka.
Weba kujuzo moyo.
And then they fill you with the Holy Spirit.
Moyono yemurokole.
And that is a born again.
If you don't have the Holy Spirit.
Mwanga toina moyo mtukufu.
Even if you are praying in Balokole churches.
Mwanga sabira makanisa gaba.
You are not yet born again.
Obera tonda bakulokoka.
If you accept.
Mwokiriza.
To be born again.
Okulokoka.
You must look for the gift of God.
Oino kuno nyachitabo cha.
That is the Holy Spirit.
Yemoyo mtukufu.
I remember the believers.
Tujukira bakiriza.
In the first church, the church of the apostles, they met the apostles, the followers of John the Baptist, and they asked them, "Mwafuna moyo wa mwakiriza?
Did you receive the Spirit whom you believe?"
Nibagamba nokumulira tutumulira ngako.
We've never even heard about him.
Nibamubabulira.
And they told them about.
Nibabasaka emikono.
They laid hands on them.
Nibajula omwoyo.
They were filled with the Spirit.
Nibogera ne munnimi empya.
They spoke in new tongues.
Obulokole obutandikira.
And that is how salvation.
Ne bwovudde mu church.
Even if you've left.
Nodai wamwe natete.
You go back to natete.
Waliwo atalabikana maso asigalanga akulondoola.
An invisible person that keeps on monitoring.
Nga yakugamba okichokola kibi.
He tells you what you're doing is wrong.
Todda mukunywa beer.
Don't drink beer again.
Your family jivemu.
Leave that family.
Ye mikwano togena najo.
Don't go with those friends.
Oyo ye musumba wo.
That is your shepherd.
Bwakuvaako.
When he leaves you.
Nsole mbinga sikulia.
The wild animals will come and devour you.
Mukama mulungi.
Amen.
Kakati. Olutwagala ku thing tons of gaggo wechirokole.
Now I've started talking about the
obakuwangula omuzimu about chikolimo chobwavu.
Overcoming the curse of poverty.
What did kusabira?
Even if we pray for you.
Ebimu tebijja kubaawo.
Some things will not come to pass.
Singa foundation yote liwetu.
If your foundation is not like that.
It's not too late.
Obude tebuna bakuyita.
You can accept.
Even if you've prayed among the born again,
years,
and you never confessed, or you confessed and you backslid. Most of you, that is how you backslide and then you
rise up again.
But when you rise up again, you don't go back to register your names. How many still love me?
Banji mwagwa.
Men of your backslid.
Wave Uganda ngojudde omwoyo.
Left Uganda when you are feeling.
Watuka mu America nogwa okumala omwaka gumu.
When you go to America you backslid for a year.
Watuka Canada nomala nogwa omwaka gumu.
Backslid for a year.
Mugenda mu ndonga eyo. Eno wabiti yango kaneka tedite lyakumanya.
No one knows you that side.
Mu clubbinga. Oloza wamala
yo. You think you made it.
Watuka mu guru.
You think you went to.
Ogirango ofuna ya akalimu.
Then after you get a job.
Ogenda okulabanga nakoteka kube.
Then you realize it cannot even sustain
you. Uganda.
Then you make a phone call in.
Papa Munange, you are the one who pray. Who sent me?
Go and kagwe yansindika.
Munange, you sent me.
One
I remember you even anointed me. But things are not moving well. Have you forgotten that when you reached there, you left the Lord and you started clapping. You started doing all sorts of things because you were excited. You've never seen in such a city. You think that it's called Jerusalem of heaven.
Then you realize that whatever makes wealth has already left. All of you in the diaspora. Unless you confess salvation again. There are few people who don't backslide.
Otukisele no compromising.
Comes
da Bible kamanywa ko katonolo lutoluo.
Says drink a little for.
Abasinga mwagwa.
Most of you already backslid.
Obulokole buchali mu Africa.
Salvation is only still in.
Bango kuva kumacha.
Because from morning.
Olaba miruluza biswa.
You're looking at herbs. You're looking at anthills.
Sere.
You're looking at all those herbs.
Olaba misota. Karungu. Novo kanote mu nyumba. Olaba bisodde basezi kati kugamba tuli excited
tewesunga
noberawo
and you're there.
Omanyi obera mbera nga tulina sente obera mutukuvu naye omuntu nga ofunye ku
sente
zinenge gizikukyusa n'olaluka nibwo obeeraano Kampala ogwa ogulayo akamotoka ka Subaru wano makeeru n'olyoka okadduka manyi Subaru edduka
n'olyoka
egyeyo obutaala neko Chojira kila chekola.
It does what you command it to do.
Why should I go to church again?
It's not unical kwa mzalwachi katenzida yu mkanisa.
Orono mkose ni club ya Basubaru.
You know, you even have a club of the Subaru drivers.
Eh, Basubaru. Tukena kula road, bajita road chi. Road trip.
We are going on a road trip.
We are going to.
Tugenda wa.
We are going to drive 20 Subarus.
Subaru avili.
We are going to Hoima.
Tugenda Hoima.
Vroom, we, mnamwe kapise. Mwe kapise, mutadevi chupabia amazi motoka.
Have water bottles in the car.
Stopover, gena kubera wano.
The first stopover is going to be here.
Mukubeye simba tokele nkoko kumi.
And let them roast for us at 10.
Buli muntu chitundu cha nkoko.
Even what it have.
Kwa nkoko namba namba.
The whole chicken.
Nemwe sarama chini.
And then you wear chains.
Nemwambala sneakers.
And then you wear sneakers.
Eh? Nemugala wo.
You wear shirts.
Mwakambi kula Subaru.
And then you drive your Subarus.
Orono nakuruwa Sunday.
No, that is a Sunday.
Okusabateri.
There's no prayer.
Mwe mtu kufunga duka.
The Holy Spirit runs.
Agangkuleke devi Subaru vyo.
Says I've left you with your Subaru.
Oinokula mantocha naziteka mafuta.
You realize you don't have money for it.
Oinokula angabakunye nyakumulimu.
You realize that.
Ante umutukuwali, agwali kukuruwanili na waguduka ku.
True that was sustaining you, ran away.
Echali chinyueze mi intu vyo mikono juchigenze.
Whatever is establishing those things in your hands has already.
Sipanyo wachitegena.
Do you understand?
Eh, na bugaga bubeyo liyate mbusanga kumoyo.
Riches increase, don't put your heart on them.
Zetoloza ante ndi musiru.
Don't think I'm a fool.
Inabudishika cha moto kechirungi.
I have every kind of good.
Buli moto keye gombi we Kampalanja.
That is admired in Kampala, I've driven.
Yogera ku Range Rover, Vogue. Range Rover Sport.
The Sport.
Eh? Maybach.
The Maybach.
Yogera kwan. Jeep.
The Jeep.
Izo zichusi za, moto kachi. Hmm? Convertible, Ford Ranger.
The Ford Ranger.
Land Cruiser.
The Land Cruisers.
Land Rover.
Rovers.
Biyo na biyo gombi wa mukama biyo badi. Nekolo zalwa sivigweram.
But why don't I set my heart on them?
Walwe yansanga wa nangamba.
Someone phoned me and told me.
Nalina Land Rover.
I had a Land Rover.
Tunda group, club ya Rovers.
We have a club of Rovers.
Why don't you come in such and such a place?
When so jamu chifo wachiti ne wachiti.
Tumere ku weekend it parkinga.
Or is there on weekend we park?
Ngama labane zikirino.
Say, look at this one.
Elida muza future yang. Nse mukama tiyajimpa, mkubange liyo group.
God didn't give me this car because there's a group of.
Namutunuli ya mutunuli.
Just looked at him.
Yani waza mukama uwaba antawalina mamoto kamarunji.
I thank God for people who have good cars.
Naba Calvini.
The Calvins.
Ba. Ah, ulidambu gift. Bagundi. Ba nansuga. Ba magi nansuga. Buba mjapa parking ku church.
They park at church.
Bide bitu bituega seko nga tulukumu ulokole.
Have come into our lives when we are in.
Kaduachi tu dira time yu ulokole atenu kujuwaba club.
Why do we give the time of bona of salvation to other people?
Yee. Wachitegeira. Ebi gambi yu nabina mukama abituwa for reasons.
God gives us all those.
Ebi intu yu nabide wenga kubawa malala.
These things should never bring you.
Bible kabugaga bweyo ngirangatubu sang komoyo.
Bible says when riches increase, don't set your heart on them.
Eraba nange, mwa magi, ba Calvini. Ba, nimwenda mwenda na haba labi manji vienda ba ku church muli kasera.
Those are the people that I see at church always.
Chokanga muli nevi yu mevi somro batu alani mbera mklabu.
Did you have cars that can take you to class?
Anange, thank you so much.
Mweva renew.
Keep it up.
Mukusigaribu ya mutio.
Te baba kema.
Don't be tempted.
Bagenda bajakaba nyuele zanko ebintu ebiyo.
They will take away from me someone who established.
Oh, you can start again.
When those people.
Otani kokole insobi kumirimu.
You start making mistakes at work.
Cheba kulabanga mbagenu kwa antubacha achiraba.
What they saw in you, they will not.
Ngaba kuriplacing.
Ngaba teka wa umulala.
Ogenu kulabanga mtu katuchasula juwanidi.
Then you realize you cannot even sustain having a.
Tuchasula nyumba kujisasula.
Can no longer parent for your house.
Oru tutanso kudamchado.
Now you've started going back to the village.
Nuzi chinto cha achiraba.
I think you understand.
Mbabuli de.
I've told you.
What excitement here abantu kibafuna.
There is that excitement that.
Wakagende London.
When you've just gone to London.
Eh, And you
see that your life has really changed.
Mugana ange, be excited,
brethren, be excited but control yourself.
Katonda
so that God doesn't
run.
So what you need.
Banga, wali excited,
if you see that walio chamuse and then you backslid.
Atega tu wachifa ako.
And you didn't give it attention.
Wade, buba wangua.
Even if you backslid,
there
is still an opportunity for you to confess again, and Jesus comes back
in. Yesu wada,
when Jesus comes back,
the
Son is going to give you power to make wealth.
Imba, sala, don't
I'll pray for you because I don't know
you. Katona, ajiteke mukasero.
But God will get that prayer and put it in
prayer.
That dustbin and he was selected.
Oh, you touch Alimuana.
That one is no longer a child.
Miracles
are food for the children.
Oh, you fuka muntu wa Katonda.
He became God's person.
Nina kusoka kufa kubana.
I'm going to first care for the children.
And
most of you in the diaspora,
you
fell the first time, but you need to rise again.
What
you came was not at the right way. Anything can
happen.
But anything can be forgiven.
Regret
what you did and then you confess again. And the Holy Spirit will return in
your life.
Then you'll see things starting to change. Don't allow anyone to lie to you that God cannot. When God forgets, he forgets.
Tajukira.
He does not remember.
Bible
the Bible says, he will not rebuke you all days.
Sota tukozenge mikorabia febitali bia butukiru webiri.
He has not done unto us as per our unrighteous acts.
Nengo buvanjuba.
But as the
Bible
is far from the west.
That is how far he
has put us.
Sota libijukira.
And he will remember them not.
Once you recall. Confess,
no, malo yatula.
The Lord will erase all the sins and give you a new file. Then the accuser will not have power over you. Amen.
Amen.
I want you
to listen carefully.
Unemployment.
In salvation.
Tuba tumanyi nti.
We know that anyone who will make wealth, they don't just do a job.
But there is a God-given job. God knew you before
you were born.
So every
time you do a job that God knew, that is where your riches are.
Amen. Christine, course you are so much in your column.
Christine, the course that you studied is not what you're doing.
It's what you did.
Yes.
What so much?
Social sciences.
Or college.
I'm an HR practitioner.
Mkama iwezu. Church or kabu choose.
It just changed.
Echo mkama chiyari yalaba.
That is what God saw.
Nga mumuli mwa mkisagwe.
That is where her blessing was.
You may
even find that through that job, her husband will come.
Just keeping an example. I'm
just giving an example.
Amen. Sometimes
it is because of these jobs that we get known.
Now, some people are blessed because they are serving me. But through service,
you may find that
at
Maria, the
person
because she's serving
me.
And maybe that is what will cause her to be known.
Ani amulaba. Mumbulire ku rugamba. Bamulaba. Kandi tujja byogera kedda. Mukama yebasi. Okay. Employment. Chechimoku bintu ebisooka okumenya.
Is one of the first things that break.
Naye nsoose okubagamba, you first break the curse.
First told you so kumenya
chukuru. By accepting Jesus Christ.
Kukiriza Yesu Kristo.
Number two, you fight the evil spirit.
Norana no moyo mubi.
Many times I tell you that Ugandans think that moving to places of opportunities will change their lives. And they ignore fighting poverty as a spirit. Can I repeat this? So many people get visas and fly to Canada. They go to America. And even desirable places. You go to UK. South Africa. But going to those places may not change your life financially. Because a spirit is a spirit. You can't run away from a demon. A demon doesn't need a visa. It doesn't need a
ticket.
Before you go, it has already arrived. So you have to fight poverty as a spirit first and bind it, put it down, then begin to work. And not every job, but the right job from the Lord. You need godly direction. Direction is the mother of greatness. You remember, Jesus told Peter, cast your net yonder or that way. Praise the Lord. Cast your net there. Don't cast it here. Cast it in poultry. Cast it in this. In lands. Amen.
Amen.
If you receive the guidance of Jesus, where to cast the net, you'll get a big catch. The spirit which you have to fight as Ugandans is the spirit of copying jobs. Amina.
Amen.
Amina.
That demon of copying jobs.
Someone has started a petrol station. Because you have money, you start one.
Now we're not handy kaya
indala. Omukisago, lisigwa omukisago.
Your blessing is not your blessing.
So you have to fight poverty as a spirit through prayer.
Kuita mukusaba.
Once you get the right job to do, there are other things you have to do to fight poverty. Like giving 10% of your income. That one helps a lot to fight poverty. Amen.
Amen.
There are
people who have a poverty that is generational. That generational poverty.
You
have a local church and that is where God planted
you.
Whatever you do, I call it immunizing your money. You've gotten your 200,000. Get 20,000. And put it in church. And you're like this, the rest will be safe. But that will
be straight.
If your life is straight. And it's not that you got born again. Then you went
abroad
and then you left salvation. Some of you, what they call they don't understand
online.
Even if you keep on fellowshipping,
even
if your friends changed, you left salvation, even if you're still praying. Am I clear? Am I clear? Maybe you're in Dubai. When you got there, you lost jobs. And then you started being a prostitute. But as you pray,
the one
pastor says,
and now
you also
you are outside the will of God.
From your prostitution work, or you are
Wayatroblokoze Uganda, yes.
You confess salvation in
Uganda. Watukeri wasigalo liko online, yes.
Because there you stayed online.
Kakati the work you are doing now is not acceptable before God.
Tekukirizwa maso ga Katonda.
You will never overcome poverty if you are still outside the will of God. I mean, you're living, you are not in the will of God. Many times I talk about doing the will of God and you yourself to be in the will of God.
Slows
and business,
it is God who created for you. Even if you earn money,
slows and
I don't think it is God who created it for
you. Outside the will of God.
So you find
yourself.
Even if you jeer, you'll get a bad disease and you'll come here.
Like
so go slow when you're jeering me. I'm seeing you're wearing
black.
It is all
glitter.
I don't know whether I'm seeing you.
You have a watch out.
Why are you jeering? We get
dizzy. Thank you, Jesus. Hakati. Tamalokterera. Okay. Poverty. Obwavu buno obusikire.
You know this generational poverty. If you want to overcome
it.
Apart from praying, even if you pray and you fight the demon of poverty.
We, you
have to know this. That if you don't tithe, and you don't just tithe,
church,
put it in your local church.
Do you understand?
Put it in your local church.
Omuntu koloza ndi wanwaliwo musumbawo. Jobotwala local church, jobotwala 10%.
You need to take your 10%.
Bubanga okungana nange.
If you fellowship with me.
Ninga nsinze musumbawo.
But I am not your pastor.
Sinze nkudamu, sinze nkusabira.
I'm not the one who prays for you.
Mukwano gwange.
My friend.
Sina chenyeza kuongerako.
There's nothing that I can add.
Choli no kola ngozo wano.
What you have to do when you come.
You can give an offering.
So rokwa echiwe wayo.
Osanga ibe tusonda not sonderako.
As doing a fundraising, you can also support us.
Ndoko ogena no sonde sende zemba ganga sijoge, sijobeda.
For weddings and for meetings,
you
can do that.
But you have a pastor who
has
made
you what you are.
Yes. Sister, I'm seeing you crying. Don't cry.
Sister, I'm crying. Don't cry.
Look for my number and apologize. I can pray for you and you leave the street. And you go abroad and you make money. In a sensible way.
The Lord is good. I'd like to inform you.
Employment.
It may not take away poverty. Until when
directed by God.
And you're doing a job Katonda gwe yakulungamya okukola.
Amen.
Amen. You may get 3 jobs. But how do you choose one? Let your heart help you. Your heart can point at a job. Among the 3. And you feel at peace.
omulimu gw'owuliddemu emirembe.
A job in which you feel at peace.
Gwe kugenda okukuyamba.
Is a job that is going to help you.
Yes, kugenda okuyamba.
It is a job that is going to help you.
Oluusi bw'olemererwa okusalawo.
Sometimes if you fail to decide.
Sinkana abasumba bakuyambe.
Meet your pastors and let your pastors help you.
Kubanga gwe mulimu gw'abasumba.
Because that is the work of the pastors.
Okulungamya ekisibo.
To guide the flock.
Ekyo kyekyo.
That is it.
Now, ng'oggyeko ekimu eky'ekkumi.
So putting aside the tithe.
Bw'oba oyagalira okuwangula obwavu.
If you want to overcome poverty.
Fubanga nnyo okulabanga.
Endeavor to
weyama ekintu mu kkanisa okikolanga.
That when you pledge something in church, you do it.
Era Bayibuli erina kyeyogera mu Ecclesiastes 5:4.
The Bible says something in Ecclesiastes
5:4, 5, and 6.
Tano nya.
Egambe etya?
Ecclesiastes
5:4.
When you make a vow to God, do not delay to pay it, for he has no pleasure in fools. Pay what you have vowed. Better not to vow than to vow and not pay. Do not let your mouth cause your flesh to sin, nor say before the messenger of God that it was an error. Why should God be angry at your excuse and destroy the work of your hands?
Yes. Many times, the work of our hands is destroyed by God. Why? Because we make vows before God and we don't fulfill. Even if you are employed, you will never overcome the spirit of poverty. Bobanga tokwata kalamu kuwandika nti neyama kino.
If you don't get a pen to write that this is what I
meant.
Some of you pledge verbally.
Ne mutawandika ne mwerabira.
And then you forget.
Kati ekyo sitani nakozesa ekyo.
The devil uses that.
No okubeera nti okola ki? Sitani nakozesa ekyo.
The devil uses that.
Okubeera nga abba obatta ebintu byo.
To steal or to kill your things.
So bw'oba oyagala okwangula omwoyo gw'obwavu.
If you want to overcome the spirit of
weyamenga.
You need to
ate otuukiriza ebintu bye weyame mu kanisa yonna.
Pay whatever you have pledged in any church.
Kubanga Katonda tebamuzannyirako.
Because you don't play with God.
Amen.
Amen.
Pozi nekisembayo olw'obudde.
The last thing in the interest of time.
Mukama bw'anaba ampadde obudde obuwanvu nja kukiddako.
If God gives me a more time, I'll come back to it.
Bw'oba oyagala okwangula obwavu.
If you want to overcome poverty.
Bulijjo.
Every day.
Mukama akuwa ekisa okumanya.
God, may God give you the grace to know.
Nti wateekwa okubaawo amaanyi agakuteekebwako okola obugagga.
That there should be power imparted on you to make wealth.
And
then you will establish his covenant.
Abantu bano balina amaanyi babaako endagaano ya Mukama.
Power, they have the covenant of God.
Amen.
Amen.
Kati bw'obeera nga tolina ndagaano ya Mukama.
So if you don't have a covenant of God.
Kiba kizibu okuteeka imparting obugagga.
Difficult for you to impart wealth.
Kubanga eba ndagaano.
Because it is a covenant.
Nze bulijjo njogera sikinkwasa nsonyi.
Every day I talk about it.
Mukama yakola endagaano ku bulamu bwange.
God made a covenant upon my life.
Ampa amaanyi.
He gave me power.
Okugaggawaza abantu.
To make people rich.
N'angamba nti bajja kujjanga nga baavu.
He told me they will come to you poor.
Bagagawalire ku bigere byo ng'obalaba.
They will become rich at your feet as you watch them.
Amaanyi gano nange gankoledde.
This power has also worked for me.
Ne gakyusa obulamu bwange.
And it has changed my life.
Olwo nno kyengaba nkirina.
And I have what to give.
Ate era nina bye ngabidde ne mbalabako.
And there are those that have given and have witnessed it.
Calvin y'omu ku bo.
Calvin is one of them.
Talina bingi.
He doesn't have much.
Naye we yatandikira si waali.
But he's not in the same stage as when he started. Even at his age, he wouldn't have the things that he has. The people that he grew up with in
Bulam.
The people
oh, is
the people that
he's at high school. Si kadongo, kadongo pasta kanyi ya somera yo. Ayaza kadongo. Ya somera wa. Kampala parents. Tubasanga be mwaso bana bomwenka.
Nabo
bavuga Subaru
ngabo. They also driving Subarus like you.
Mm-hmm.
No.
Ujja kwesanga nga bali awo. Ate abavu b'ekibuga balimba. Bamanyi okwesala obuweero. Tomutegera nti talina ssente. Kasaba nga alina oluzungu. Amanyi okusanirira akalevu. Tebava mu saluuni. Bamanyi okwambala obulungi. N'asala bulungi olukuubo mu mutwe. Oba n'akola ebyo ebijwenge by'oku mutwe. Ebyasebuume ebyo. Okitegeera. N'alyoka ajja n'akuliisa oluzungu. N'olowooza ne waleeti ezitowa. Kumbe wa talina kantu.
They have nothing.
Amen. So yeah, what you talk about power to make wealth. Amanya ngo mukama asobugateka ku muntu.
God can impart it on someone.
Amen. Kati nsaba Katonda tuyambe.
So I pray that God helps us.
Tusobola okuwangula obwavu.
Can overcome poverty.
If you have the right job, I'm going to pray for the jobs.
Kusabira emirimu.
I know right things. I remember there is a lady who testified. I told her, prayed
for you to get a
car. Counseling.
She came in counseling. So she used her own means and
money.
And she hadn't even learned how to
come.
They parked. Say, Pastor. Here is your prayer answered. I told her that's not it.
Yes,
that's not the car that I prayed for you.
Nazala kilo.
And then she felt
disappointed.
Then she was
disappointed.
I told her, don't worry, I'll also pray for that. But that is not it. So she kept quiet. But my God is faithful.
Why it
after some time, she called me.
Nangambo chimani.
Told me, do you know?
Katonda mpadde motoka from bond.
Aka from the bond.
Sent her towards Jehovah, ma'am.
Where did you get the money?
Nangamba.
And she told me.
Omuntu omutwalwananga naye.
One person we used to
fight. Ngali mu mataka ga kitange.
Another in my father's land.
Naye.
But now.
Nafuka mulabe wange nnyo.
They became my very, very bad enemy.
Naye ankubidde essimu.
But they called me.
Nangamba wange.
And told me.
Walingo manja.
Used to demand me.
The sinner sent.
I don't have money.
Jangu mbondi nalisa motoka zange nyingi oronde mujo ya gara.
When I brought a car.
Kutereko msoro girovuga.
Then I'll pay taxes and you start driving.
Na alonda na gambi enu.
And she said this is
the only driver ya agenda amufukira ya agenda nai.
She went with her friend who was driving her.
Na agenda balonda motoka nipajiteka kwenye namba nipajita kuchaji.
And they brought it to church.
Na mgamba hiyo.
And I told her that is it.
Sitani yabadde akuzizise kino.
The devil had given you this one.
Era ekyo n'akinoonyeza akigula ne sooka kidiba. Naye baakimusiba nga tekitunda nno.
No, it was not a selling.
Nekibeerangawo nga kipaakinze nga beevugira kana akapya.
It was parked and they were driving a new one.
Uzanya ne Mukama.
You're joking with God.
Mukama afeebazibwe.
Praise the Lord.
Njagala kusaba nkome wano.
I'd like to ask you to allow me to stop here.
Naye nga njagala kugamba nti obwavu buwona.
But I want to tell you that poverty can be healed.
Ekikoligo kisobola okukotoka.
The yoke can be broken.
Naye sagala omalegali nyenyonyi genda bweru.
To just board a plane to go abroad.
Nga tumaze kuwangula bwavu.
Without us first overcoming poverty.
Tusooke tubuwangule ku mavivi.
Let us first overcome poverty on our knees.
Tukusomesa okuve.
And we teach you.
Mubikuletako ekikolimo.
And you get out of the things that bring a curse upon
you. Okukungaana.
To learn to fellowship.
Olwane n'obwavu.
And you fight with poverty
mu ngeri ey'omwoyo
in a spiritual way.
Era bwona oba okimaze.
And after you do it,
n'ofuna omulimu.
And you get a
nze njagala nnyo omuntu asooka akolereko wano mulabe.
I want someone to first work from here and I see them.
Eno enjogera yange ennaku zino.
This is what I say these days.
Ne bw'oba nga omwoyo guli bwe guba gukutusoga obwavu.
If that spirit of poverty is broken.
Ogukutoolako.
That spirit that reduces from you.
Ne bw'oba otunda mudala gwa nyaanya.
Even if you're selling at a stall.
Ennyaanya zigwawo tezivunda.
You know your tomatoes can never rot.
Oyinza okwekangamu mu nyaanya omwo okuzeemu ekintu.
You find that out of selling tomatoes you've done something good.
Bw'oba owangudde wano.
If you've overcome
here. Ne bw'ogende Canada owangula.
If you go to Canada you overcome.
Bw'oba owangudde Uganda.
Overcome in Uganda.
Ne bw'ogende USA owangula.
Even if you go to the US you can overcome.
Ne bw'oddukanga tonnawangula wano.
But if you run away when you've not overcome, whatever you do, apply for a visa to go abroad. You're wasting time. You'd rather lose out here than find someone to give you free
cassava.
Apart from making losses
in America,
where there's nothing for free. Me as thinking, don't first apply. You need to first fellowship and we pray and we pray.
And then
these ones are disturbed by the spirit of poverty. Spirit of poverty was disturbing.
Okay. As I finish, why do we pray for jobs?
Rush to serve medium to serve medium.
We pray
to serve
for jobs
to serve for medium
because.
We want jobs that God has favored. Jobs that are going to
bring
prosperity.
Allow
me today to pray for jobs.
Because
I've told you that not every job.
The
people that look
like people
you spend the day at home
seated. But when
you ask them, ever since this year started, what have you done?
You work,
you leave home.
Okay, may I
spend
my time?
I haven't gotten a job.
But the
sustenance.
Sustenance.
Sustenance that you can know that the one you give responsibility is
working.
But I dress even better than you who is working. It means that Jesus that I gave the
responsibility
to look for a job. He's
looking for
that is why he's
looking
for it. I get to the other job when I've not fainted.
Do
you see how good
looking?
Don't feel bad because you don't have a job. God is working on
something.
Even if you pay it through faith. If God wasn't with you, they would have cast your things outside. It takes the favor of
God.
Some people even have parents.
But
their parents cannot even
build
a house. Not because they don't
love them.
Some they cannot even do
it.
But you see the grace of God. If you can pay. Even if it is your friends that
you.
It takes God. I want us to thank God.
We
need to trust him always because he's with us.
Amen.
Amen.